Hello. So soon we're going to get into really understanding the meat of why you want to use agent-based modeling and what it's good for and what it can help you understand. But before we get to that conversation, I think it's really important to try and have some insight into some other uses of agent-based modeling, places it's been used in the past. So over the next couple of talks, I'm going to be talking about some simple introductory models where it's been very powerfully used, and then also some more complex models where there are things that might be interesting to take a look at. So let's start with a couple of my favorite models, actually. And I chose these models primarily because of the fact that they're easy to understand, but also because of the fact that they have some powerful points to discuss. So the first one I'm going to discuss is called the FIRE model. So you want to open up NetLogo, go to File, Models Library, and then underneath Earth Science, it's usually closed up like this, you'll find the FIRE model. And once you load that up, you'll see something that is just a black screen, very simple to use. This, by the way, is the interface tab of NetLogo. It allows you to run models and interact with models. And so the first thing you're going to want to do is hit the Setup button. When you hit the Setup button, you see a layout of the model. Now, this model is very, very simple. The basic idea is that every place you see a green dot is a tree, and every place you see a white dot, or sorry, black dot, is a place without a tree, right? And on the left side of the screen, you'll notice that there is a red line of fire, right? Well, in fact, that's what we're calling it. It's fire, essentially. The rules of the model are very simple. If a fire agent, in this case, in these cases, touches a green dot, in other words, a tree, it turns that green dot red. In other words, the fire spreads from the red dots to the greener dots. Once the fire has spread, it leaves behind a lighter shade gray dot. And the idea is that that fire then can't re-spread to that same area, right? Once you burn the tree, it's burned for good. So right now, the way this model is set up, you'll notice that there's a slider up here, is what we call the NetLogo. A slider controls one of the input variables for a NetLogo model. And right now it's set at 57%. And what that slider is controlling is how many trees there are in this world. In fact, you can look to see, so it's setting is 57%. If you hit the settings button, you can actually see how big the world is. So in this particular world, it's about 251 by 251 pixels or squares, patches in this particular case, right? And so 57% of 251 squared is the number of trees that are in this world. And these trees, by the way, are placed randomly. It's just a random roll of die whether or not a tree gets placed on a particular patch in this case, right? So what we're going to do is we're going to hit the Setup button that we already hit. That creates the world. And now we're going to hit the Go button. And the question I want to ask you is, with 57% of the world covered, and knowing the rules we do about the fire, which is that the fire can only burn the green patches, will the fire get from the left side to the right side of the world, right? And this is a simple question, and of course there are reasons why you might expect it to do it, right? 57% is more than enough. In fact, if you were to set up the patches, right, you could set up the patches in a straight line such that only 1 over 251 would be necessary to actually go from the left side to the right side of the model, right? Because you just need a straight line of trees all the way around. So here's the question. Will the fire get from the left side of the world to the right side of the world? Don't try it. I just want you to write down your guess first, kind of think it through your head. And we're going to run it a couple of times and see what happens. So if you hit Setup, again, it just restarts the world, same conditions. And we let the model run. It spreads, but slowly starts to die out, and in fact it stops, right? So let's try it again. Maybe that was a fluke, right? And we run it one more time. And the fire spreads, and it spreads. But then, again, you see the different strains, and they start to die out, right? And let's run it one last time. And it spreads, and it spreads. And by the way, down here, you're seeing the percent burned. That's telling you what percent of the number of trees actually burned, right? In this case, 7.2% of them burned, which is kind of small when you think about it, because this whole side of the setup is set to be much bigger than that, right? So now I'm going to move this slider, this little density slider. I'm going to move it up just five little increments to 62%. I'm going to hit setup. And I'm going to hit go again in a second. So now slightly more of the world is covered, right? 5% more of the world has trees in it, right? And the question I ask you again is, will the fire make it from the left side to the right side? So give you a second before I start it up and run, but to write down your answer, to commit to it. So I'm going to go ahead and let it run now. And as you can see, the fire already is hitting numbers, percent burns numbers that are much higher than they were in the 57% space. And sure enough, it's hit the right side of the world. It's still going, in fact. It hasn't burned out yet. And we can run it again. And as you can see, it slowly transitions. But you can clearly see that it's just spreading much farther. It's spreading to much deeper places than it was before. And, you know, it's hitting numbers in the 88, 89 percentile range in terms of the percent burn. Let's run it one last time. And while that's running, let me describe to you a little bit what's going on. We've actually detected what's sometimes known as a phase transition in this model's dynamics. And a phase transition occurs in a traditionally, we think of this as a transition from something like solids to gaseous forms, right? Or from, usually it's solids to liquids and then to gaseous form, right? Sometimes you can get straight through, but, you know, along those lines. Or gas back to liquid, back to solid, right? And those are what we traditionally think of as phase transitions. What that has come to mean is any model dynamics in which a small change in an input parameter, in this case the density slider, can dramatically change the outputs of the system. In this case, that the fire goes all the way across the world and then a lot higher percentage of the world is actually burned. In fact, because we've studied this model actually in some respects has some closed form solutions to it, when that slider is at 57%, we know that there's almost a 0% probability or zero probability that the forest, that the fire will actually go from the left side to the right side of the screen, right? Now, it's not completely zero. As I explained, you could just randomly roll the die such that the trees align perfectly across the street. But it's darn close to zero, right? On the other hand, when it's up at 62% at the other end, right, then we know that there's almost 100% probability that the fire will go from the left side to the right side of the screen, right? And at values in the middle, like around 59, 60, for instance, there's a moderate probability that it'll transfer, right? But this is clearly what we would describe as a phase transition. A small change in the density parameter leads to a dramatic change in the output of the model.